recorded yet today.
Hello, everyone. Oh my god, you're gonna actually put this on the internet?
It's 8:18 a.m. later than yesterday. Oh my god, look at that view of jazz now.
We got the lemon leggings and the
Class is starting. Class is starting. Gotta go.
Hi! Oh my god!
Wait, hold on! We are currently at the DanceMakers wrap up show.
Is a man on the floor?
If he ain't, let me know.
Hey everybody!
I'm back.
Hey,
vlog.
Is this a video? It's a vlog. It's a vlog.
Hi everyone. I'm at the closing show.
Lucy, I found her pen. I found it on the floor. It was where I was sitting.
It's Ainsley, Mackenzie, and Leah. And all C and Anna are back there.
And here's Carissa. And,
yeah.
That's cute.
Yeah. Okay. And Marissa's here. And Catherine.
And Callie's here.
And Callie's here.
Hi, vlog.
And you don't get the camera.
Okay.
We're at the show.
Wrap it up.
Okay. So we're gonna end you here.
But mwah. There are little kids like sitting on me right now.
Hey guys, so this might be the worst I've looked on my vlog yet. So breaking records today. I'm sitting in a very random spot on my bedroom floor right now because I'm dirty. I'm about to get in the shower, but I was all over the hotel carpet today, basically, in classes. I definitely didn't get as many videos today. Everything just felt super rushed today, but also, like, we were just kind of feeling good in the classes and, like, spending time with each other, like, our whole studio. And it was also super chaotic from the class transition into, like, the wrap-up show, where we were super crammed on the floor watching, like, an hour and a half of, like, dances and awards and scholarships and all that stuff. Today, we started off the day with jazz. It was really great. We breathed together for like 6 to 10 minutes and it was super like relaxed and chill and like we all were on the same page. We're like, we're tired, but we're gonna get through. So that was a really good like start to my morning. The majority of the teachers I really enjoyed at this convention because like I didn't know who any of them were before I came in, but most of them were like super chill and like I just felt really like comfortable in their class. Next we had tap. It was funny because literally everyone from our studio dipped, like they were all out. But I stood with Austin kind of in the center, but we didn't want to get too close because we were like scared because we're not good at tap. And this convention was actually cool. They had mini like wooden tap boards thing. I guess they had a limited amount, so the people in the front, if they wanted to, they could like tap on the board so it would make noise. So we were just on the carpet so you couldn't hear us. But that was better for me because I was messing up all the steps, so if you could hear me, they'd be like, girl, get out. Then we had two contemporaries in a row, both of them being continuations from yesterday's combination. So the first one, now that class, I kind of wish I got a video of the choreography because towards the end I actually got the majority of the choreography, which I was very surprised. Like I definitely didn't get all the little like intricacies or whatever the choreography, but the gist of it, I was like, okay, I feel good doing this. It flowed really well. Like I really like that. And then lastly, I guess the most notable point of my day, our last contemporary class of the day, it was Justin's contemporary. This was right before lunch. So again, we continued the combo from yesterday. It was a really simple combo and I really liked this teacher. I feel like he was probably my favorite teacher of the weekend just because he made us feel so like comfortable and like he was asking us what we needed. And it doesn't surprise me because looking back, I have indeed cried at every single competition in like a hotel bathroom or once I got home or in the car ride home. Today, the only difference was that I cried in contemporary class, like in the class, like in front of my whole studio. Should I lie and say that I didn't cry about it in the car on the way home too? No. No lying on this channel. That's why, like, my eyes, like, burn right now because I was, like, crying so much for no reason. Like, literally no reason. Like, am I okay? I'm fine. Oh, basically, the gist of what happened. It's not that big of a deal, even though I did cry about it multiple times today. But it's not that big of a deal, I promise. Ew, there's something on my foot. What the F are you? Who are you? Is that a tit? These little ass bugs have been, ew. You little shit, ew. Guys, I'm saying this freaking hotel, I'm dirty right now. Ew, ew, ew.
If that's a tick, I'm,
stop. Oh, thank God I caught that.
I need to get in the shower ASAP, Rocky. Okay, let me get this.
Sorry, guys. Okay, it wasn't a tick. My mom thinks it's from my plant or just like bugs from the outside when the windows are open. I don't know. That.
Where were we?
I was crying. Okay.
Hey, guys. So, quick little disclaimer. You might be thinking as I'm talking about this little incident that happened in class, this really isn't a big deal. Why do you care so much? You said multiple times that you don't really care, but you're still upset about it. To clarify, I feel like this was just a buildup of a bunch of emotions from like every single competition and convention that I've ever been to. And like all of a sudden I just like felt the need to like let it out. I'm glad I did because I don't know if anyone else feels like this too, but it is really difficult to go to these conventions without being trained in a super technical, strict studio. But I'm so glad that I'm not trained in that way. I'm just saying it's difficult when you're not used to that. It's a great experience. It's good to challenge yourself. And at the end of the day, Dancemakers, thank you so much for an amazing weekend. Me and my friends literally had the best time. But I just wanted to clarify that definitely like did not like ruin my weekend or anything. It seemed like a lot at the end of the video. I just feel like really all these moments of me feeling not good enough and really discouraged kind of like accumulated, and then I just kind of let it out here. But yeah, just wanted to clarify, we're all good now. I just had to have my moment, let it out. But maybe you can relate to it, and if not, lucky you. Okay, bye.
I just really struggle with this, and I know I mentioned right before, like, at every competition I've cried this year, and I'm not trying to be, like, a big crybaby, like, I don't get noticed, I don't get pushed to the front, teachers don't like me, I don't get scholarships, because it's not about that, it's really not. It's just a tough pill to swallow, because I feel like the whole dance industry, and, like, maybe not the whole industry, but, like, mainly where I'm, like, training at, and, like, the classes that we go to, and the conventions we go to, most, if not all of them, are about, like, dancing from your heart. Like, you don't need to be perfect, just like dance, do it for you, and like your light will shine. And basically I just struggle with this because like I love dance so much, and like I get to class and like I really feel like I give it my all, and that's what happened in today's contemporary class. I just felt so in it. I was like, I know I'm not perfect, but like I'm feeling the music, like I feel very comfortable with this teacher, I feel very comfortable in this environment, and I felt like really good about myself for the most part. Like, I'll just get upset because it's like, okay, I really gave my all in this class. Like, it would be nice just once if I could get recognized by a teacher, by a friend. And I know it's a bad quality to just like seek this validation, but it's just like I am so self-conscious in like so many ways in my life. Like when I dance, like I just want to feel so good about myself, and something I've been doing for, this is my what, 14th year dancing, something I love so much. It just sucks because it's like, yeah, my technique's still not perfect, yeah, my feet aren't the pointiest, yeah, like sorry, like I'm sorry, yeah, I forgot my solo on stage, yeah, it sucks, and I wish I was better, and I could get down on myself for this for so long. And I just feel like after every competition I come home crying. I'm like, I'm not supposed to feel this way. Usually at a convention, teachers at the end of class will pick out like a couple students, it could be like 8, it could be like 20 to do in groups, but normally they pick out a select number of people that they thought did the dance well, or they caught their eye for some reason, and they get to do it in front of everyone. And at the end of the day, doing something like that would make me nervous, but at the same time it would be nice to know that like you're working your ass off, and then you get a little reward, you get a little recognition for something that you're doing. Which I know it's so bad to think this way, but it's just like, I've been doing this for so many years and I've just never once gotten recognition of any kind, and I'm just like so tired of it. But then it's hard because like you're gonna look at my dancing and be like, okay, well like you're not that good, so like what do you expect, sis? But like if I'm dancing from here and all this talk of, oh, if you dance from your heart you'll shine through, well I'm not shining apparently yet. Sun is not shining on me today. Basically, I'm always down on myself. I'm like, oh, I wish I could just go out there. I wish I could be in the center of the floor. And then today, somehow, the opportunity presents itself. And the teacher's like, can I have 8 volunteers? Exactly 8. So I didn't think much of it. 8 people go out into the floor. They do the combo. And we form a circle around them. It's like a circle around them. So everyone can, like, feel our energy. And it's really, really good moment. And as you'd expect, the groups follow 6, 5, 4. He's asking for specific numbers of people. So then I think actually it was the second group of 6 that I was like, okay, like I'm gonna force myself to go in the center. Like, this is what you want. This is your senior year. This is your last convention. And the opportunity presented itself right there. So I was like, okay, Alexei, push yourself and just walk out. I didn't even tell anyone I wanted to go in. I just walked in. So I'm maybe the 4th person in the center of the circle that chose to walk in. And he asked for 6. So then 2 more people come in. All of a sudden, 4 other people come in. So obviously there's like 10 of us. The teacher says over the mic, he's like, guys, like work it out. Like us, like we're mature enough. Like someone has to leave the circle. There's too many people. So then I stand my ground for a couple seconds. So then I'm like, you know what? Like, it's okay. Like I'm going to go out of the circle and I'm going to try again. So I go back, which honestly, maybe I should have just stood my ground the first time, but that's what happened and I can't change it. So I went back. Fine. Those 6 people do the combo. They do a great job. Then the next go around, he's like, okay, can I have 5 volunteers? And I'm already a little bit hesitant, but I'm like, okay, Alexia, you need to push yourself because I am always down on myself for not standing up for myself. Then he asks for 5 people. The same thing happens. I go in the center of the circle. Again, I think this time I'm literally the first or the second person in the circle. And again, like 10 more people come in and I'm standing my ground. And this time I'm like more determined, but I'm also like I'm literally shaking. Like I'm so ready to like go in the circle, but then go back to my group. Cause basically we're all in a circle and like Angela Bates Dance Academy is taking up this whole 1/4 section and they're all like staring at me. So then I like look back at them. Then I like look at the teacher. I look at the other people dead in the eyes in the circle that I'm standing with, basically competing for space. And then I look back at my team. They're all like, Alexia, don't move. They're like, stay. And I'm standing there. I'm like, guys, I can't do it. And literally the first time I came back from the circle, they were like, why'd you leave? I was like, guys, I can't take space from other people. I'm not someone that wants to go and shove someone out of their light. Like, yeah, I might go home upset, but at least someone else gets their moment. And that's just how I think. It just sucks because it's like, literally every time I'm crying about this, I'm like, I want the opportunity. The opportunity is here. So why couldn't I just stood there, looked at other people in the eyes and said, this is my turn. Sorry, it's my senior year. This could be my one and only opportunity to maybe have a little bit of recognition in the center of a circle. I can stand my ground. And I thought that for a second, but a couple more seconds went by and I'm thinking, I don't want to be the bitch that's in the middle of the circle that's going to stand her ground and not move because she wants to dance and she wants to take that spot from someone else. So of course, another couple seconds go by. I'm literally like, it's crazy because my body is so stiff. My body's telling me like, Alexia, stay right here. But then my mind is like, no, like you can't take this space from other people because I'm looking at these other people and they're not moving. And it just sucks because also in this senior room, there's like 13-year-olds. Like this is not normal. These 13-year-olds are standing here like this, like looking at me, waiting for me to move. Everyone's kind of like shifting, like waiting for someone to leave, but no one actually does. So then, you know, at the end of the day, who gives up their spot? I do. I go back out of the circle and I just start crying. Like, I don't even know what overtook me, but like, cause even my dance teacher, she was like, Alexia, go back out there, go back out there. And then she's like, next time you just go and you stand and you look them in the eyes and say, this is my turn. And you stay. And that's exactly what I should have done, but here I am. And then after that group goes, he's like, I need exactly 4 people. I need 3 people. Everyone's like, go, go, go. And I'm just like, no. Because I'm defeated at this point. I don't even think I remember the choreography at this point. And now I don't want to be the crybaby that's like, oh, you get your chance now, little baby, okay. Like, I don't need people treating me like a puppy dog. And, like, I appreciate everyone's, like, support and stuff. I'm just like, it just sucks because it's like, to me, it just seems like such a dream to walk in a convention. Like, there's some incredibly talented dancers. And you just know you're getting scholarships every time. You're being called on stage to, like, help them assist. People tour with them. People become, like, part of their companies. Like, it's insane. Like, it's freaking insane. And I watch all these people and I follow all these people on social media that are going touring, doing all the stuff with these conventions, and I'm just like, it must be nice to be a really good dancer. Like, it must be nice to be an incredible dancer. And it sucks because I've been doing this for so long and I still feel like I suck. And then it's just like moments like this happen. Today I literally had the opportunity I've been waiting for. Not that it was some big show or anything that I was going to be in, but literally all I need, I just wanted a little moment to myself in the middle of the circle just to do the dance. It's really not that much to ask for, and I should have just stood where I was, but I decided to leave because I don't want to be the person that causes other people to leave the floor. Like, that's just not me. I don't want to take up space, and that's the problem, because I should take up space. I need to assert my dominance in the middle of this. I really do. And it's just like, it just makes me really obsessed. And I left, I just started crying because I was just, first of all, I'm like, crap, like I really want to be in the center of the circle. Like, I really want to do it because, like, I feel like the teacher didn't really notice me yet. And like, not that I was doing anything spectacular, but like, I felt the choreography. Like, oh my god, I'm not crying. I don't know. So I basically just started crying. And then it also just too, because everyone else was like, go in. And I was more just upset too, because I was defeated at this point, because I had more opportunities to go in the center. But at that point I was like, I don't want to go in the center anymore. Because even if I go back in, I'm going to come back out because someone else is going to take my spot and they're not going to budge, but I am. Because I'm the nice one. It just sucks because I feel like I'm always getting like little moments like this taken away from me. And like, I'm just not standing up for myself. And like, I should have just been more confident, but I wasn't. And at the end of the day, I should have just gone harder in these classes. Like, if I want this so bad, like maybe I need to do more. Like, I'm not enough. It's freaking fine. That's fine. It's just annoying after so long. Like, you just want a little bit of recognition. No one admits it, but everyone wants just a little. Like, I watch all these closing shows and I'm just like, I would kill to be in a number like that. And it just sucks too, because it's like everyone at conventions like, oh, so lovey-dovey, we're all friends. Oh, but then at the end of the day, people are only hyping up the people that can do quadruple pirouettes into a triple backflip into a straddle split. Like, sorry. Like, I'm sorry, I can't do that. I'm sorry, I can't do 72 fouettés in a row. I'm sorry. And I'm not upset. I was upset earlier, and I'm just getting upset thinking about it, that I, like, let myself down in a sense. But it's fine, and I need to learn, and it's just gonna be a tough pill to swallow. I may just never be recognized for anything, and that's fine. And then I can't be Ariana Grande's backup dancer. Shit. I hate myself, okay. fun dance trip. This is always how my dance trips end, but normally this part doesn't get on camera. Well, the fact that I literally had bugs crawling on me earlier means that I need to get in the shower, so I'm gonna go. And no, I didn't want to like end it like this. I just like wanted to be like real, because it's like this stuff happens, like it's all fun and games, but then you go back to your hotel room and you cry about it. I was in the hotel bathroom using their dry ass tissues, like trying to blow my nose, trying to look normal, but my mascara was like disgusting. We're not gonna talk about it. It's over. It happened. Period. This is my number from earlier. I'm gonna take it off and hang it on my wall like I do with the rest of mine. Despite me being emotional, no, it was a really good weekend, and like it was just really emotional. It was like our last time competing as a team, but we are gonna do all these numbers at recital. I can take you along that journey as well if you'd like. Oh my god, it's 8 p.m. I have school tomorrow. That's disgusting. I'm really hoping this didn't turn into a 30-minute vlog like last time, but if it did, you're a real one for staying through the end. Once they come in, I definitely want to post some of the competition videos, so stay tuned for that, whether on my YouTube or my Instagram. Feel free to like and subscribe if you'd like. I hope you're having a swell day, and bottom line, don't go to a dance convention. I'm kidding, totally go to a dance convention. It's such a good experience. It's so fun, it's so freaking fun. Thank you guys so much for watching, I hope you're having a great day, and I will see you soon, hopefully, with a Coachella vlog. Guys, I'm vlogging Coachella. I will see you soon. Bye.